back. Summer's best. we have intermission.
Oh, intermission.
Oh, man, that is one of the best parts of the show.
We've got the police. That's a great show. Questions about, your work, your creative process, we will answer.
Alexa, what's that character's name?
Marvin the Martian.
Marvin the Martian?
I like him.
He's always like, man.
Yep. He reminds me of work.
I'm really sick.
Work. Where do I go? Can you go home? Oh, yes, we can.
I have a lot of questions.
But that's why we're here.
I was thinking about, you know, a lot of plays are sort of produced now. What of those things do you think are useful to live? Missions, dramaturgy, workshopping, some new plays do seem kind of forced and they seem to work better. Are any of these tools good?
Remind me of your name.
Yolanda.
Yolanda. It was some Y. Is it going to start with a Y?
Yeah.
Yolanda with a Y. Wonders. What's good? So if you're thinking about getting your play produced, what's helpful and useful? Dramaturgy, workshop production. What else? Do you
think? Even like before, like I know that you, like back in the day, you stayed for a long time to write the play. To me, that seems really alien. But you know, I also think as a director of another part of my life, you do work on things.
Right.
In rehearsal, things translated.
Sure.
What of those kind of things do you think are important?
I work with a committee, meaning, I mean, different things are helpful for different writers. Different writers find different things helpful, as always, right? So some people, I've heard of people, wonderful writers bringing in just bare bones, trusted actors, and saying, you know, let's put this on its feet, and they find out a lot that way, and they write it that way. And other writers are totally extreme and, you know, just bringing in and don't change a word ever, you know, throughout time. So they're extreme, and different things work for different people. And what you want to do is experiment on what works for you, and as you said, you have a life as a writer and a life as a director, so different things work for you in different situations. And all of us, we don't need to get locked into one way. It worked that way that time, so I'm never doing it differently. You know, maybe an opportunity will present itself that sounds appealing. That said, you're right, Yolanda, there is an institution like the workshop training and the dramaturgs, you know, get in there and they get cheated. It depends. It really depends. If you have someone that you, a dramaturg, for example, that you love working with, oh, they're a wonderful person, you know, then of course you want to give them your play to give you advice on and stuff like that. If they're just a random person assigned to you, I would say proceed with caution. You know, it's like dating. It's really like dating. Are you going to, you know, maybe you do get down during the first date, but you know, maybe you want to have them take you out to dinner for a couple of times and to maybe talk to some of their friends. You know what I mean? So it's just like dating. In this situation, it's like a date. But I do this in a dating situation. Really go forward. That's what I, you know. Just because it's an institutionalized thing doesn't mean it's bad, but it doesn't mean it's for everybody. So you should really do what's comfortable for you. I'm not a big workshop person, but I do believe in the workshop process. I mean, I'm having a play workshop in February. Not because it's workshop, because instead of doing it out of town at first, which is the way they used to do it, they didn't just sit in their lonely rooms. Like Eugene O'Neill would start this play in Connecticut. You know what I mean? They would travel to August 1st and used to do this play all over the place before they got here. So it was a tradition of lots and lots of productions, which one could equate to the workshop situation. Okay, so
it's not as alien as I think.
Yeah, exactly. It's just the new incarnation of that they used to be well done and often done. You know, so it's just a new incarnation. It's the same thing all over again. Just what's comfortable for you.
Just the way they talk to you.
like the people you're working with and go forward. If you don't feel like it's good for you, then take slower steps and smaller increments. That's fine.
So you found all of those things.
Different things at different times. You know, there's a dramaturg, John Diaz, who now he runs a theater, tours of a theater in New Jersey. So I love talking to him about my work. Emily Morse, who now is on the staff for years now at New Drama. Love talking to her about my work. She used to be at Midhouse Drama in Philadelphia. John used to work here at one of the places. I love talking to people. I love talking to them. I don't like talking to people about my plays. I don't like talking. It's the person, not the institution. You know what I mean? Does that make sense? So there's a way to do it, and then you say, well, I'd like to do it this way, but it's the person. Like marriage, it's a great thing. If you're married to someone who's cool, right? Marriage is an institution, right? You're not like this marriage, you know what I'm saying? Marriage is playwriting.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
So you have pages.
Yeah, it's always, yeah.
Great, so how, so say you have X number of pages, right? So divide up, so do like, do a portion of those pages every day. So you say you have 100 pages, you might do like 5 a day or something. Rewrite 5 pages a day and march through it like that. So it's not so overwhelming. One bite at a time, or 5 bites a day. So you keep, you have your goal. It's like Everest. I've never climbed Mount Everest, but I imagine they do it one step at a time. They don't just go, oh, the mountain.
You know what I'm saying? Right? They do, they go.
And they're holding on to a rope, right? I think. It's on pictures. You know, sometimes they look up and they go, and they put on like oxygen, you know. And they just do this, right? And that's what we do when we rewrite. Or write, even. You can say, I can say you're writing a page a day or a one word at a time. I break it down really small to make it manageable. And if it feels overwhelming, I step back and do a little less every day. So if say 5 pages a day, for example, feels like you're like breaking out your sweat, you can't really sit down, that's what you have to get. Break it down 2 pages. Or do time, 30 minutes a day. And aim to get it done by, say, the 15th of October, and then do it again by the 15th of November. So have 2 rewrites. Okay? Yeah. So that's always something good. Break it down. It's always really, really helpful.
I have a question.
Yes.
Hi. So this is kind of in conjunction with this question.
Yes.
It's not about writing, but it's about creativity.
Yes.
So I have a long list of songs that I've worked on for my career. And I get overwhelmed because I don't. I've started breaking it down in chunks and doing like the timing like that. But part of me is like, I don't know if I should just focus on one song and say, you know, week, you know, after 2 weeks, I'll have this song completed, or during the day, be jumping around. And it's like, I think I'm trying to get a sense of completion.
Right.
But I also don't want to be so narrowly focused.
Right.
So I'm just curious, like, what your suggestions on. And I know people talk about just in general, like, in the writing projects. How do you suggest doing that?
Right.
So are you learning the songs, writing the songs?
I'm learning.
So you learn how to, you sing?
Yeah.
And you play an
instrument? Piano to get Tommy Hornet.
Okay, so basically the deal is you're learning songs to sing.
Yeah.
So what are the components? You need to learn tune.
Tune. Rhythms, the words, the word.
And what else?
Like where to place it, like vocally specifically, like
right.
How it's going to fall.
Right.
And then on top of that, then the act behind it.
Back behind it, right. So there's all those components. And you said you're doing, you think you're doing how many songs?
Like right now I have like 3 or 4 that I want to master.
Then you want to master over a period of time.
I kind of like to get them done.
When?
I'd say by the end of September.
In September.
But I feel like that's being unrealistic, maybe for September.
To perform in front of people?
To feel, yeah, I guess that's another step, is to get them up in front of people, to kind of workshop them.
Why mid-September? What's happening? That's just the kind of deadline, the finish line that you like. Okay, so one thing that I heard,
Lauren.
One thing I heard Lauren said, to master that word, to master. I love that word because they call me a master writer chair. It implies something. But I suggest taking that word and putting it on the side. Because mastery might take a long time, like finishing. Being totally done, ta-da, I'll never do another rewrite again, I'll never change a word. It might take a while, but you can get to a point where you can give it to people to produce, right? So mastery, let's put that on the side. Because mastery, or it might come after you've been singing the song for 5 years. After you've been singing the song brilliantly, bringing tears to the eyes of your audience for 5 years, you might go, no, I mastered it now. Or after 10 years. So let's let that one go. We're gonna lower the bar. Okay, now. Can you learn 4 songs in 4 weeks? Yes, you can. You can learn 4 songs in 4 weeks.
you're not going to master them, but you will learn the rhythm, you'll learn the tune, you'll learn the vocals, you'll learn the words. You just, I would suggest, instead of working and thinking, I don't want to be too narrow, she said, that's like your little mint bugaboo thing.
Don't be too narrow, you should be doing more. Work harder. Work on all 100 at once.
Talk to the hand. I'm working on whatever song, you know, whatever, Oklahoma, we'll just name that one, since maybe that's not one that you're writing. Although the lyrics are pretty good. I'm just working on Oklahoma this week. You're allowed to listen to other songs. If you're just learning Oklahoma this week, you're allowed to sing other songs and enjoy warm up your yoga. You're just working on Oklahoma. Because what happens is, yeah, the overwhelming factor. I'm going to learn one song a week. No, no, do it all at once. That's when you get overwhelmed.
And then forget it. No,
right? And we were all going through that privately or publicly. In the public. So, yeah. One song at a time. Use your strength and your focus to just say, I'm just working on this song. Again. A paper calendar, blank paper calendar, or make one, and write down song of the week is such a day, whatever. Okay? And just keep your focus. Have your song list, like you have your scene, you have your written play. Type out your song list or write it out, and then pick that song. This is my song for this week. I'm just going to learn this song. Period. Anybody else who says, you should be learning more, or you should get them in just kind of. And if you do it that way, you'll be able to cross the finish line in good shape. Okay? It's really important. We're just learning one song at a time. We're rewriting one page at a time, or one line at a time. We're just doing one thing at a time. And that's a form of discipline. Just to do that takes a lot of strength. Okay? A different kind of strength. I've talked about the courage of writing and the courage of rewriting. There's the courage of writing where anything grows and everything goes. And there's the courage of rewriting where we have to actually slow down. Writing is fast. You just want to get it out there. Your list of songs, just come. Do it, right? But then rewriting, you have to be brave in a different way. Just smooth. Slow way down. Tai Chi, a really slow. Yeah, I don't know, whatever that was. the Karate Kid movie, whatever.
Talking about songs. Any advice on writing songs? I've been reading songwriters on songwriting. That you had. I had it already.
Oh yeah, right. That's cool.
And it started me like sometimes waking up in the morning with some song in my head.
Right.
But I don't know what to do with it. You know, so I got a little tape thing.
Good.
To sometimes sing it, and that's about as far as I've got.
Right. Well, you write down. Okay, so Carol's talking about writing songs, and she wakes up with a song in her head, and you have a little tape thingy, and you sing into that. Do you have a way to transfer it to something more permanent than just a tape, you know, on a tape? Or, you know, can you download it to your computer?
I think it can.
Okay. Okay, but you can. What you do is you can download it to your computer, make files.
Do you write out notes on paper like the old days?
Well, you could if that's what you want to do. I mean, I like using, you know, the iPad Mini. It's not a plug. So much of
iPad Mini.
The little thing that I was, you know, I like doing the old school and the new school. I love typing on iPad Mini. It's like crack. I'm sorry, it's not crack.
But it's kind of funny, like the song comes.
Well, just write it, sing it in, and then write it down. I would just do it as if it were a line from a play or something that you're writing. Treat it the same way. Write it down. I mean, get it in a form other than the tape recorder kind of thing, which is sort of like easily lost. So try to download it to your computer or type the lyrics out. You know. And then if you can sing the tune into your tape recorder, you can note where it is on the tape recorder, like 005 to 27 or whatever. You can
balls were stuck? What's a way to return to the initial feeling? We just said, what's your name?
Julia?
So we can get lost or stuck, but we all get lost or stuck. At least I do. Or I get lost or stuck so often that I never, you know, right? Okay. And it's good to get, I mean, I think I said the other week is, I thought the other day that, you know, guides, G-U-I-D-E-S, must have been people who, they get lost often. Because you can find your way out, right? So it's a good, it's not a bad thing to get lost and stuck, because you have to figure out, what do I do? You know what I mean? So, some of the things that I do, and this is the thing, to return to the initial feeling that got you started in the first place, that's kind of a tricky bit there. It's kind of like mastery. Maybe the initial feeling that got you there in the first place isn't what you should be returning to. So if you're looking for that, maybe you're looking for something that's no longer there. Okay? So don't worry about that. Let that go. Okay, that might have just been the thing that got you here. Okay? What you want to find, it sounds like to it, is you want to find the thing that gets you writing it again and loving it again. Right? It might not be the same thing as the beginning. Okay. Time is the best. Time heals all wounds. Time will do it. Put in the time. If you can honestly say, I put in 45 minutes a day, an hour a day on this work, and I just can't find it. I put in an hour a day for 2 weeks, and it's just not there. You know, then, you know, we'll try other things. But put in the time, right? When you walk around during the day, a lot of times when we're stuck, we walk around, and in our heads we say, instead of that, try saying things like, I really love you. I think you're going to be great. I really think it's going to work out. You know, I'm so close to figuring it out. You know, I can imagine myself already like writing in the flow. I can imagine myself in the flow of writing it. It's going to be great. It's really wonderful. I just got to keep up the timing. Like a kid, like I have a little boy, right? You know, if every time he like, you know, he's trying to say, what was he trying to say the other day? Yogurt.
So
you go,
yogurt.
I'm like,
yogurt.
So we did that for like 10 minutes. Yogurt, like that. But he was doing it. But if I had gone like, I'm going to yogurt, yes, I mean, ooh, boy, he'd have, you know, right? He wouldn't be speaking at all.
Your work is the same way. It will retreat. Sometimes it just needs some encouragement to come out, like a turtle. It'll come. You show up for it, it'll show up for you. I've been writing for 100 million years, and that has always happened. It might not turn out exactly like I want it to. I often don't get back to the feeling that got me writing it in the first place. Rarely do I get there. I can't even remember why I started writing most of these things. But if I show up, it shows up for me.
Whatever it is that I love, that I know I love. Oh, love.
for sure. That guy over there who just had that show, I'm sure he just walks down the flowery garden path. You know? Everybody is wrestling. Everybody, most everybody, cries all along. There's a lot of gnashing of teeth that goes on off stage. It's like a Greek tragedy. We're like, hi-ya. Everybody cries. It's going to put you in touch with your shit. And you 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 out there, and you and you. And, you know, that's why we do this, right?
Because we want to know.
And we want to know. I should came home with me, by the way. Let me stay in the room. Thank you, JP. Thank you, Jordan. Thanks, Jesse. You're okay.